It is not good that man should be alone. Therefore a man and leaves his father and his mother and cleaves to his wife as they become one flesh. As two colored sands are now being blended into one, so two lives are blended into one. May you be one together, one in aim, and one in happy destiny together. Your gift to each other for your wedding today has been your wedding ring, which shall always be an outward demonstration of your vows of love and respect and a public showing on your commitment to each other. You now have that what remains the most honorable title which may exist between a man and a woman, the title of husband and wife. For your first gift as husband and wife, that gift will be a single rose. In the past, the rose was considered a symbol of love, and a single rose always meant only one thing. It meant the words, "I love you." So it is appropriate that for your first gift as husband and wife, that gift would be a single rose. Would you please exchange your first gift as husband and wife? In some ways, it seems like you have not done anything at all. Just a moment ago, you were holding one small rose, and now you're holding one small rose. In some ways, a marriage ceremony is like this. In some ways, tomorrow is going to seem no different than yesterday. But in fact, today, just now, you both have given and received one of the most valuable and precious gifts of life. One I hope you'll always remember. The gift of true and abiding love within the devotion of marriage. Andrew and Jessica, I would ask that wherever you make your home in the future, whether it be a large and elegant home or a small and graceful one, that you both pick one very special location for roses, so that on each anniversary of this truly wonderful occasion, you both may take a rose to that spot, both as a recommitment to your marriage and a recommitment that this will be a marriage based upon love. That yet, in every marriage, there are times where it is difficult to find the right words. It is easiest to hurt who we most love. It is easiest to be most hurt by who we most love. It might be difficult sometimes to say, "I am sorry," or "I forgive you," "I need you," or "I am hurting." If this should happen, if you simply cannot find these words, please leave a rose at that spot which both of you have selected. For that rose then will say what matters most of all and should overpower all other things, all other words, and all other activities. The rose that says the words, "I still love you." The other should accept this rose for the words which cannot be found and remember the love and hope that you both have shared today in this very few moments. Andrew and Jessica, if there's anything you remember of this marriage ceremony, it is that it was love that brought you two here today. And it is only love which can take you through life together. It is only love that will make it a glorious union with each other. And it is by love which your marriage shall endure. May God's blessing be upon you. Let us pray. Oh God, you have so consecrated a covenant Christian marriage that it is representative of covenant between Christ and His church. We ask God that you would send your blessing upon Andrew and Jessica, that they may surely keep their marriage covenant, grow in love and godliness together in their home, and their home may be a haven of blessing and peace through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift the light of his countenance upon you and give you peace now and forevermore. Amen. Andrew, you want to kiss your bride? It's your bride now you're kissing. It's not your girlfriend. You're kissing your bride now. Well, I guess I'll let you, okay? It's really a pleasure and honor for me to introduce to you the first time this Mrs. Andrew Dimony. May God bless you. Thank you. Thank you.